Dear students, today we will try to learn about Krafft temperature and cloud point. So what is a Krafft temperature? Here first we will go through this figure. When you plot a graph between concentration of surfactant or surface active agent versus temperature, this is the x-axis, you are increasing temperature, and this is y-axis, you are increasing surfactant concentration. Okay. So when you increase the concentration of the surfactant and also increasing temperature this way, for example, if you take this temperature, so it is solubility, that means it begins to increase. How you will understand this? Suppose we have a test tube in which we have put the aqueous solution of suppose SDSR, any surfactant. When we refrigerate it, suppose to 4 degrees centigrade or -4 degrees centigrade or below 0 degree, you can write it as, so it will result into the formation of hydrated crystals. These surfactant or surfactants or surface active agents, they will form solid hydrate at the bottom, and above it will be the liquid, suppose it is aqueous or simply water. So now what we are doing to this, we are taking this test tube and increasing it. Is here you will see its solubility is very less in this aqueous phase. Now we are increasing the temperature. So when we increase the temperature, its solubility begins to increase. This region you see here, it represents a structurally enhanced region, or you can say that it is a solid hydrate of surfactant, a hydrated surfactant simply. Now when you increase the temperature, its solubility increases. Up to this point, here when we also see that at a particular temperature, this is the this line, it is the CMC line of the surfactant. So when the solubility and the CMC, they actually cross over at a point or at a particular temperature, and at which the solubility then increases abruptly. Okay, so this temperature at which this solubility curve cuts the CMC line or CMC curve here, this is called as Krafft temperature. So you can see that above Krafft temperature, its solubility is increased very, very rapidly, and it results into the formation of micelles. So you can also say above Krafft temperature micellization occurs, and below Krafft temperature it will result into the formation of hydrated these surfactant molecules here. So basically what we are doing here, it just plotting the graph between concentration of surfactant and temperature. You can see one more graph here, what I was talking about. This phase represents solid plus solution. What I have shown you, that when you decrease or refrigerate a solution of surfactant, it will result into the formation of solid phase and this liquid. This solid phase contains surface active agents and this is liquid. So that is why this is written as solid plus surfactant. But as you go on increasing the temperature, at a temperature where the solubility curve crosses the CMC curve, that is called as simply the Krafft temperature, which is represented as KT, or this is also called as Krafft point. So this is temperature, Krafft temperature, and where the solubility curve and the CMC curve, that is called as Krafft point. Okay, so this region here, the solubility is very, very high. As we are after this Krafft temperature, then it results into the formation of micelles plus monomers, what we have seen, some monomers there, and plus spherical structures of micelles. So that means this Krafft temperature is very, very important for surfactants above which they can form micelles, or their solubility increases abruptly. This is also one graph depicting the same situation, but we have already learned that this way we are taking the concentration in millimoles or molar solution, and this is temperature in degree centigrade. So the point at which this solubility curve and the CMC curve they cross, that is called Krafft point, and the corresponding temperature is called as Krafft temperature. Okay, so these figures, these three figures basically show the same point, that is the Krafft point and the corresponding temperature, Krafft temperature. But what we have basically learned from this, this is applicable to ionic surfactants, cationic or anionic. So the solubility first increases gradually with rising temperature, what we have seen from above figures, and then above a certain temperature there is very sudden increase of solubility with further increase in temperature. The above figure basically illustrates that with the the last figure, it was basically of the experimental curve of sodium dodecyl sulfonate in water. Okay, the same figure also shows the variation of CMC with temperature. The solubility of the surfactant clearly increases rapidly above 22 degrees centigrade. When we go back to this figure, we are talking about this figure. This is basically of sodium dodecyl sulfonate. This is experimental curve, basically about 22 degrees centigrade. This is almost 22 degrees centigrade here. What I have done it, you don't have to remember these values. This is just an example to show to make you understand that this is basically a particular temperature, Krafft point. Okay, so for this surfactant, it is sodium dodecyl sulfonate, it is basically 22 degrees centigrade, and after that the CMC increases gradually with increase in temperature. You know the CMC, that means the tendency to form the micelles. When you increase the temperature, obviously the CMC will increase, that means you need more and more number of monomers to form these spherical structures when you increase the temperature. Why? Suppose a surfactant was making micelles at, suppose, this 25 degrees centigrade spherical structures. So now what you are actually, this is always in dynamic equilibrium with the monomers. So these are monomers in the solution also, and this is spherical. But when you increase the temperature, obviously their entropy or their temperature will increase, and randomness will increase, and exchange capacity also increases, and they require more and more number of monomers. That means we have, it will include more number of monomers now to form the micellar structure. So basically it results into the increase in the critical micellar concentration when you increase the temperature. So at a particular temperature, the solubility becomes equal to CMC. What we have there, the crossover point, that is the solubility curve intersects the CMC, and this temperature is referred to as Krafft temperature of the surfactant. But what we have seen in the above example for sodium dodecyl sulfate, it is 22 degrees SDS. Okay, this is SDS, this is anionic surfactant, sodium dodecyl sulfate. So here this is sodium dodecyl sulfate here. Okay. Now you have to remember a few points regarding this Krafft temperature. First point is, at the Krafft temperature, basically an equilibrium exists between solid hydrated surfactant micelles and monomers. You know solid hydrated surfactant, what I have shown you, that suppose you take a test tube or a beaker in which you have an aqueous solution of surfactant or surface active agent. When you decrease its temperature or refrigerate, it will result into the formation of this solid hydrated surfactant plus aqueous phase. Okay, this is they are like solid hydrated crystals also. So at Krafft temperature, an equilibrium basically exists between this solid hydrated surfactant micelles. Some of the micelles will be in the aqueous phase and some monomers. Okay, so the Krafft point is basically a triple point. You have to remember this. It is basically a triple point where the three phases, you can see monomers, micelles and solid hydrated surfactant, they exist in an equilibrium. Okay. So since the Krafft boundary represents the region below which the crystal is separate. So if you decrease the temperature now of a surfactant solution, simply the crystal is separate. That means these solid hydrated surfactants, they separate out. The energy of crystal lattice is the most important parameter controlling the Krafft temperature. That means they fit into what we have already seen in this figure first. Okay, I am going back to the figure first here. Here, basically that means it basically forms these solid hydrated crystals. That means these surfactant monomers, these were the monomers. Their randomness simply decreases and they form these type of crystal lattices here. Okay. So when you increase the temperature, randomness increases and they ultimately result into the formation of these monomers and then monomers and micelles. So this is what we have done here. So now the second point is surfactants with ionic head groups, cationic or anionic, positive or negative. I am talking about this head group, what we have already done. This is the hydroprotein, whether it is positive or it is negatively charged. So ionic, these both positive and negative, they will be simply called as surfactants with ionic head groups are compact, highly polar head groups and long citrate alkyl chains will have high Krafft temperatures. So if you are supposed to make a difference on Krafft temperature, suppose you are being given two surfactants, one is having a long chain, other is having a short chain, but head groups are same for those, you can say which will be having the high Krafft temperature. Or similarly, out of the two ionic head groups, which will be having the high Krafft temperature. So next point is here, that means that the Krafft temperature increases with alkyne chain length of the surfactant molecule. Same what we have shown, that keeping the surfactant head group same, suppose sulfate group, anionic group, and increasing the tail length, suppose this is the head group of the surfactant, and you are increasing the chain length. Suppose it was first carbon 12, now you are increasing to carbon 16. So that will simply increase the Krafft temperature of the surfactant. It can be reduced by introducing branching in the alkyl chain. Suppose if now branching is introduced into the alkyl chain, it is Krafft temperature can be reduced very drastically. You can see this phenomenon. These are simply called as, when you have one head group and simply a tail, these are called conventional surfactants. But we have one more type of surfactants. Those are called as Gemini surfactants, where they have two head groups or two tails, and they are just joined by a spacer here. Their head groups are here joined, two head groups, two tails. These are called Gemini surfactants. Gemini, G-E-M-I-N-I. So obviously, when you take these in place of these will be having low Krafft temperature. Or if you, by some chemical means, you can introduce some branching in the alkyl chain length, that also decreases the Krafft temperature of the surfactant. So what is the significance of decreasing the Krafft temperature? That means you can form micelles at very low temperature of the surfactant. You do not need to have high temperature for the surfactants to form micelles. So, okay, now moving to the next point. Using alkyl groups with a wide distribution of alkyl chain length can also reduce the Krafft temperature. Oh, I have already seen this. So the Krafft temperature is basically very important in application of surfactants. The solubility of surfactant increases significantly above Krafft temperature, and hence most industrial applications require surfactants with low Krafft temperature. So those surfactants are basically used in detergents and all these soaps which have very low Krafft temperature. Suppose if a surfactant has 20-30 degree centigrade or 40 degree centigrade Krafft temperature, for that what you need, you have to first increase the temperature up to 40 degree of the solution, then you can take the advantage of their micellization, or they will form after that froth on the surface of the water or in water, and after that you can simply wash the clothes. But if you have such surfactants or surfactant agents which have very low Krafft temperature, that means you do not need not to worry about the temperature of the solution, just you can add and they will form the froth, and you can simply do any industrial process or just washing and any other process related to the surfactants. Okay, next now is cloud point. So Krafft temperature was basically, it is characteristic of ionic surfactants, that is whether they are cationic or anionic. But what about non-ionics? So they have basically cloud point. So aqueous solution of polyethylene oxide, or those are called POE type of non-ionic surfactants, if the oxyethylene content is below about 80%, if this chain, this is basically oxyethylene chain, if that is below 80%, they become turbid on beating. Suppose what you have, how to determine the cloud point of a surfactant, what you add, you add in a test tube, suppose an aqueous solution of that surfactant. Okay, now what you are doing, you are increasing the temperature. You are increasing the temperature. A temperature will be reached when it form, when the solution turns out to be, it becomes turbid. Okay, the temperature basically here, the temperature becomes turbid on being heated to a temperature known as cloud point. That temperature at which the solution becomes turbid, that is called as cloud point. It can also be reversed when you decrease the temperature at which this cloudiness disappears. That can also be called as cloud point, following which there is separation of solution into two phases. Basically here separation of phases takes place, that means surfactant and aqueous solution. This phase separation occurs within a narrow temperature range that is fairly constant for surfactant concentrations below a very few percent. Okay, so these phases, the phases appear to consist of almost micelle free dilute solution. Here that means no micelles are there micelle free dilute solution of non-ionic surfactant at a concentration equal to it is CMC at that temperature and a surfactant rich micellar phase. That means one will be a rich in micellar phase, another in another phase, because when phase separation occurs, one phase will contain the surfactants in the micellar phase, others will be not in the micellar phase. So this just basically appears above the cloud point. That means when this cloudiness appears, you can easily say that one is the aqueous phase, other will be the turbid phase. So turbid phase will be always in the micellar form, and that aqueous phase will be in the monomers, in the monomeric form. So the phase separation is reversible. What I have already told you, that you can decrease the temperature of this solution and change back it into the a single phase by because this is reversible. So on cooling the mixture to a temperature below the cloud point. Now suppose the cloud point of this was 22 degree or 42 degree. When you decrease its temperature to suppose to 10 degree or 13, these two phases, that means the micellar and the non-micellar phases, they will merge to form once again a clear solution. So it is seen when you simply add surface active agent to an aqueous solution, it forms a clear aqueous solution. Okay. Now, when you increase a temperature will be reached where it forms a turbid solution. That temperature is called as cloud point of the surfactant. And simply you can, this is reversible. So when you decrease the temperature below this cloud point, it will again form the clear solution. So this is basically the cloud point. So this is generally done for non-ionic surfactants. So few points about this cloud point. The separation is believed to be due to sharp increase in aggregation number of micelles and decrease in the intermicellar repulsion resulting from the decreased hydration of oxyethylene oxygen in the POI hydrophilic group with increasing temperature. This separation, basically what is aggregation number? It is the number of monomers in a micelle. Suppose you have a micelle here. Micelle, it is made up of, suppose I am making just a rough sketch here. Suppose if I count the monomers, this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means are 9. So if these will be called, one will be called a monomer. That means this micelle is basically made up of 9 monomers. That means aggregation N. N will be equal to 9. Usually it is 50 to 100 for a normal surfactant. You can say that. So, and this is just an example. So that means you need at least 9 monomers to form this micelle. But what happens when phase separation occurs? Now you need more than 9. You need 15, 16 or 20 more these monomers to form the micelle. That means we can say the aggregation number of micelles, so it increase in the aggregation and decrease in intermicellar repulsion. Why intermicellar repulsion? That means there should have been hydrophobic repulsion. They usually decrease upon phase separation. Okay. So next point is here. As the temperature increases, micellar growth, that means when the number of monomers they increase, it will result into the swelling of the micelle. That means micelle will grow in size. So micellar growth and increased intermicellar attraction cause the formation of particles. For example, rod-like micelles, I have already told you in the start of the lecture first that micelles are not only of the spherical shape, they can be rod-like, micellar-like, cylindrical. It will depend upon the concentration of the surfactant. So that are so large that the solution becomes visibly turbid. So this spherical, they change into then rod-like micelles, and when rod-like micelles are formed, they become very long micelles, and they turn the solution into a turbid one. Okay, so one more point is phase separation occurs because of the difference in density of micelle-rich and micelle-poor phases. That means if two phases result, one, if upper phase will be simply will have low density, lower will be having the more density. It is very simple. When you have two liquids or two phases, one is above, other is below, the below one will be having the more density as compared to the upper one. Okay. So the temperature at which clouding occurs depends also on the structure of this non-ionic surfactant. So non-ionic surfactants, they don't have these cationic and anionic head groups. They basically have these oxyethylene chains where oxygen introduced between some carbon chains. So it will depend upon it, simply upon its structure. So one more figure I will show you. So we have one more point. For a particular hydrophobic group, suppose we have particular hydrophobic, that means a hydrocarbon chain, the larger the percentage of oxyethylene, this means oxygen, this carbon, then oxygen, these introduced in these non-ionics in the surfactant, the higher will be the cloud band. The more these oxyethylene groups in the non-ionic surfactant, the more will be the cloud point. Okay. What I have already told you, that these micelles are not only spherical, but they change to different configurations or different structures. For example, this is the normal micelle you are seeing here. This is the normal micelle. These are two structures. This is just to concentrate on this one structure here. This is the normal micelle. So this side, we are actually, this side, it is aqueous phases more. We are increasing amount of basically aqueous phase here. So it will form the normal micelle. But as we go on increasing now the non-polar phase, increasing amount of non-polar decreases the amount of water solubilizer. Suppose it will change into structures then to normal cylindrical. Then this will be the lamellar, that means they will arrange like these two sheets. So concentrate on one, these are same, then this is same, this is same. So you concentrate on this one, this is like a membrane. So then reverse, that means when you increase the now the non-polar part, that means you are changing now the solvent to a different solvent, non-polar one, obviously it is polarity will reverse. That means now head groups will go inside and the tails will be outside. So this is called a reverse lamellar. This will be normal lamellar, this will be a reverse lamellar. And when you increase more non-polar phase here, it will change into a reverse cylinder and then perfect reverse spherical. So these two are two extremes and these are in between structures. And now you know that now the structure of these surfactant micelles also depends upon the environment that are solvent in which they are dissolved. If it is more aqueous phase, they will form these type of structures, and their structures can change depending upon the concentration also and upon the non-polar phase or aqueous phase also. They can form these normal spherical, normal cylindrical, normal lamellar, and when you increase now the non-polar phase, they can change to reverse lamellar. Reverse, simply the hydrophilic will go inside and the hydrophobic changes will phase towards the solvent. So reverse lamellar and simply reverse cylindrical and then reverse spherical. These two are the extreme points. You know reverse micelle, then this is normal micelle, and this will be now the reverse micelle. In between these two, there are many structures of surfactant can be seen. So we have in the above example seen that when these surfactants, they change to rod-like structures, their turbidity basically increases. That means their cloud point, when a solution turns to turbid, that means cloud point appears for the surfactant. This is particularly applicable to these type of polyethylene oxide or POE non-ionic type of surfactants. I hope you understood this lecture. Just go these three figures and very carefully and see different structures. Okay, thank you.